Hey, it's Ivy. So I'm doing something that I've never before done at Whistler, and that is take the gondola back down. Usually I ride my last run all the way to the village, but the conditions were so rough today that I am not going to force it, and I'm going back down. So it had me thinking about how sometimes in life we really want something really bad, like that epic powder day or whatever it happens to be, and that's just not the case. It's just not happening. And instead of fighting it or trying to push through it, or like I saw some kid with a broken arm trying to get down some, just when snow is this heavy, it's raining and it's this thick, it's like concrete, you literally can't move. Just try to like get through it. I saw these guys who were like, well, let me just try and have a fun time by going in this out of bounds area, and they got stuck too. And it's like, sometimes if we try so hard to force something that's just not happening, we end up suffering or hurting ourselves or hurting others that we drag along with us in the process. And sometimes there's that little voice inside of you that's like, hey, Ivy, or like, hey, you, not gonna happen today. This is not the right decision right now. Don't do this. And I can either listen to that little voice and be like, okay, little voice, as much as I would love to have one amazingly epic run, I'm just gonna like play it safe and go down the gondola so I don't risk injury in these conditions. Or you can do it, but I think the more that you don't listen to yourself, the higher chance you have of injuring yourself, emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually, whatever it happens to be. If things are, yes, there's something to be said for like pushing through the challenge and developing character and becoming stronger. And sometimes there's just like taking a risk or doing something that you shouldn't be doing that will likely yield harmful results. So knowing the difference, and in your body, like your body always knows. So if you're wondering about something, you're like, yeah, maybe I shouldn't do that. And that's that gut feeling. You're like, okay, I'm gonna listen to that gut feeling. I'm not gonna do it. Or your mind talks you into it. It's like, yeah, come on, maybe it'll be good. Maybe all those other times it wasn't, but maybe this time will be different. And you're like, okay, brain, I'm gonna listen to you. And then we learn, right? So wherever you're at with listening to your body and not doing something that doesn't feel right or good, or not listening. And I know that I didn't for a long time. There are many, many, many years and many, many, many times and many, many, many bad decisions where I was like, this feels like a terrible idea, but I'm still gonna do it. And I'm learning to make the choice not to do it anymore, not to do things the super hard way, especially if they're not gonna yield potentially good results. So yeah, that was it. I threw in the towel today. You can see how wet and rainy and miserable it is. Just it should be snowing, not raining. There's lots of rain in my goggles and everything. But yeah, I'm going to take a shower and then drive to the wonderful Dr. Gabor Mate and his wife Ray's house for dinner. I'm really grateful for that, and I'm gonna arrive refreshed and feeling good that I made a good decision for myself. So I hope that you're having a wonderful day today. And encourage you to listen to your body about when it says yes or when it says slow down, maybe no. Or listen when it's like, no! And listening to that. All right. Gondola's almost at the bottom. And I'm gonna head back to Creekside. All right.